I fish up the coast. Mostly north of the coast, all the way up to Point Conception, and then I even go to the Channel Islands, so out to Santa Cruz or Santa Rosa or San Miguel Island. I definitely prefer fishing with another person. If I had a choice, I would fish with a partner. When I'm diving, I'm generally by myself. I am by myself. But when I'm trapping, I am the deckhand. I fish off of another boat when I'm trapping the crab and lobster and fish and prawns. I've definitely learned it through my dad. He was not a commercial fisherman, but he's very, into the ocean. Mostly free diving when I was growing up, it was free diving to get dinner. That's where we got our seafood, was the ocean. There wasn't an option to go to the store. Just take what we needed. I still practice that. A day of diving is, I go out to my spot, my secret spot. I dive down with, I have a bag with a float on it, and I have a rake in one hand and also a measuring gauge, because we have a minimum size limit that so I can't catch small ones. And I'll open up a few of them to see what the quality is like. If the quality is good, then I'll continue in picking those urchins, because generally they're the same one, the same quality in that area. And then if they're not very good, then I'll come back up and move the boat and go somewhere else. The idea is to fill up the bag. Before I go diving, I actually hang some other bags off of my boat, off the side of my boat. So when I fill up a bag, fill up a float, and my urchins will go to the surface, I'll swim into the boat, latch them onto my boat, and get another bag and go back and get it and fill up the next bag until I have no more bags. I bring them up on board with the davit, and I have a hand little pulley davit, less things to break on my boat. I bring them back to port, and a lot of them I sell directly to the consumer, to restaurants, and sometimes I'll sell to a processor. Part of the process of being processed is to put them in some alum as a preservative, and that does alter the taste. So there's a lot. I've gotten a lot of comments back, people who have eaten uni in the sushi restaurant and they don't quite like it, but I have them try my urchin from the shell, and it's a different story. The ocean is something I've always known. It's always, I've gotten my food there, I've played in it, on it. When I was growing up, I never liked school until my junior year of college. And I started taking the upper division marine biology classes, and I loved school and academia after that. I was given very good opportunities when I was in college. In a nutshell, I got paid to count fish. After Tahiti, I came back to Santa Barbara. I was working with the university on another project. I was counting fish and invertebrates and algae all the way from Oregon to Mexico. Do a lot of surveys. I realized that I wanted to continue, this lifestyle, this livelihood. So I went to Australia and worked for one of the best tropical marine ecologists in the world named Howard Choate. Loved it. First, I couldn't get a job because I came back before I was completely done with my dissertation, so no one would give me a job, so I didn't quite have my diploma yet. And so I got a job as a deckhand in Santa Barbara on fishing boats, and got into the politics of fishing and realized it was very similar to my grad school work. So I go to meetings, do some policy things and management things and education and outreach, and then go fishing, wearing fins one day and heels the next. During that time, I did get a job teaching. I worked my way up the ladder, and then budget cuts came, bad economy came. I finally realized that I see a better future in fishing than I do in the higher education system. So I focused on developing my business, fishing. Probably the best decision I ever made, being, you know, in the economic times, being in business for myself is perfect. As a woman in the fishing industry, I think that I'm extremely lucky. I've gotten the opportunity to learn from quite a few fishermen in the community. I think they were a little bit more open to sharing their knowledge because I'm not as big of a competition as a male my age. I think that a lot of people appreciated my efforts, my political efforts, so they wanted to help me in the, you know, with the part that allowed me to make money, allowed me to earn a living. Because the meetings part does not. Some examples of that would be fishermen want certain kind of regulations that the government just does not want to address. Or a lot of times there's some environmentalists who want to step in and try to shut us down for not very legitimate reasons. I've encountered a lot of extreme conservationists, as they're eating their sushi, they're telling me how much they hate me as a fisherman. And I find that completely ironic. You know, I've had a couple people say, oh, it's okay, because that seafood's from China. They don't want people eating seafood from their backyard, but it's the most responsibly caught seafood in the world. There's other fisheries around the world that are modeling California management strategies. You can't take seafood faster than that species or that population can reproduce itself. We're figuring out ways to find out the thresholds species by species and limiting our take. If that resource was gone, we'd be out of a job. So we're actually the biggest advocates for trying to preserve that resource. You have to think of it as the farmer's market or a fisherman's market. It's the exact same deal, except for we don't get subsidized. If there's bad weather, if there's an El Nino, if there's some kind of marine catastrophe, we don't get subsidized like a lot of farmers do. So it's just something to keep in mind. Consumers and community do need to better understand all that it takes to go get their protein source. So it's actually really beneficial to know your fishermen. For the next generations of fishermen, I hope for plenty of fish. I hope plenty of seafood. I hope for and making a livelihood out of it. Continuing to be able to have a livelihood. Because this is it's an honest living. You know, you go down to the harbor and you see us unloading all of our seafood, and you see all the fishing boats and the salty dogs and the camaraderie, and that could be replaced by a bunch of fish pens. How boring. I mean, as much as we do compete against each other, we do have each other's backs too. It's definitely a win-win, a give and take. So I'm still new at this. You know, these guys have been going for 30, 60 years, some of them. So I got a long way to go.